I'm here in Hollywood, California, where I caught up with two people who's part of Amir Khan, Francisco Santana and Dangerous David Rodella. As you guys know, Lamont Peterson failed the drug test, high levels of testosterone. He said he needed it for medical reasons. Here's Khan's response and what the fighters have to say. The fight got canceled, got pushed to June 30th. First of all, what's your reaction to all this fiasco?
I mean, first of all, you know, we're in the best shape. I mean, I'm in amazing shape, ready. Best shape I've ever been, honestly, I can honestly say that. Changed a lot of things, you know, got a new strength conditioner. We were in the Philippines training, high altitude training, hard sparring partners, like 160 guys. And, you know, we were ready. Regardless, Lamont Peterson was on something, we would have beaten him this fight. Now, you know, he's been tested positive, and I've just heard rumors that he was on the same thing, which is testosterone and steroids for the fight. For the first fight when we fought in December, so it's unfair, you know. That's why the Nevada Commission have not taken the fight on. I mean, they said, look, we're not having the fight no more, and you know, we see what happens from there now. So there's no fight now. I have to go back to the drawing board. Gonna take a couple of weeks off and then get back in the gym again. Maybe I'll have a fight in the near future.
Any message to your fans who are very disappointed right now about this whole thing?
I mean, I can only apologize, you know, because I'd love for them to see me fight, and you know, those people who bought tickets and everything to see me fight, it's a lot of money, you know, to travel from the UK. Over 5,000 people were going to fly over. But look, it's one of them things. I'm very disappointed as well, and I hope this will get fixed, and you know, they'll keep supporting me. But at least the truth is out now. Everyone knows Lamont Peterson cheated when he fought me the first time. That's the only way he knew he would win. And even though, you know, he did cheat, I still believe he didn't win that fight, because, you know, I had points taken off me. I had everyone against me that fight, it shows. But it just shows that I'm a clean fighter. And when they randomly tested me, I was okay.
Khan, Francisco sparred Amir Khan. What's it like to spar Amir Khan?
Cool, fast, good people. It's always a great camp with them. I have a lot of fun, just like I have a lot of fun with the rest of my camps. But I mean, it's always a good time to spar with Amir. Takes care of you.
What do you make of the whole situation with Peterson, the drug test? Khan now has a new opponent June 30th. What did you make of all that?
Just for this. I think that's crazy. I said, why did he admit? I would have denied, and keep denying. It wasn't me.
But he said he has a testosterone level of a 70-year-old man and that he needed it medically.
I'm not no doctor, but I mean, like I said, I would have kept that on the radar, under my hat. You know what I mean?
It's just weird because he's the one who insisted on the drug test. It's like...
But he probably didn't know no better, though. I mean, he probably thought he wasn't doing anything wrong, so... I mean, that's... I mean, why would you say it and confess to it if... You know what I mean?
Okay, I'm going to give you...
If he didn't know, I mean, I would have denied it, like I said.
Okay, Amir Khan against Eric Morales. What do you think about that fight?
One-sided.
Okay.
Well, Amir Khan would beat him. One-sided.
Amir Khan, Jesse Vargas?
I think Amir takes it. I think Jesse Vargas is still in the learning process.
Okay. Amir Khan against Juan Manuel Marquez?
One-sided.
Man, Amir's too fast. Yeah. He's too young. Marquez already too.
Juan Manuel Marquez?
On his way out.
Marquez is out.
Is there anyone? You sparred Amir Khan right now for this camp. Who would you want to see him fight now that the Peterson fight fell apart?
You know what? I heard a rumor, maybe Danny Garcia.
What do you think about that? Swift, Danny Swift Garcia. Not the trainer.
No.
I know. Not our trainer.
See, that's a good fight. Both young, both talented, both undefeated. See, that's...
Puerto Rico against England.
Is it Puerto Rico?
Yeah, it's Puerto Rico.
Oh, okay. See, that's a good fight.
He's the newly crowned WBC champ.
Yeah, he beat Eric Morales.
That's right.
That would be awesome.
That's what I said. It'd be a good fight.
That would be a good fight.
So what are you doing now that your camp ended early?
I start sparring with Vic tomorrow, on Monday.
Getting ready for Berto.
Get Vic ready for Berto. So,
man, you go from speed into power.
Speed, power, and then if in 2 weeks when Amir comes back, I might be back here with Amir again, sparring. But it's cool because I have a fight. I don't fight till July 23rd, so I have a... I got time from now, so it's cool to stay active, stay sharp, you know how that is. I'm just kicking it with Mr. David. That's why, it's thanks to this guy, that's why I got in good with Amir.
It's because of him.
He's a star now.
My boy D, yeah.
You see, that's his son, little D.
Little D, yeah.
Everybody's asking your dad for pictures. How cool is that?
I'm B-Boss, bro.
You heard? We were just saying that and it just happened.
Oh, no. Yeah. Like a miracle happens.
What story did you see him on 24/7? The exclusive story they broke about how Manny bought him a house?
Yeah, the house.
Wow, they're the first one to report it. I gotta commend them for the good job in journalism. Jack and my stuff.
With his work boots, when he came out with his work boots, y'all pushing the shovel. I gotta get those work boots.
I gotta play the part like Bauer.
I had to get the work with
you. Amir Khan, Lamont Peterson. Let's see who Amir Khan fights June 30th. BasenewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa Beck reporting.